give us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the
Lord. That you are here in the household tonight. Pray that God is going to work and move in mighty and awesome ways tonight as we get into the Word and as we get into prayer. As we get into prayer. And some of you may be looking at my face and saying something different about him. And it's just, I've been using a new beauty queen that has given me a little younger look. That's new glasses. Amen. Well, let's get into the Word tonight. We're going to be looking at Psalms 24, verses 27. I'm sorry, verses 4-6. A message entitled "In the Time of Trouble." In the time of trouble, we're going to be looking at the King James today. It's two slides. Let's read this together on three. One, two, three.
One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock, and now shall my head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord.
Amen. Tonight again, we're going to be looking at a message entitled, In the Time of Trouble, In the Time of Trouble. Tonight we're going to look at on around 3 points. In the time of trouble, I will wander. In the time of trouble, I will withdraw. And in the time of trouble, I will worship. We want Christians to know tonight that they should long for God in troubled times. They should long for God in troubled times. Amen. This reminds me, I didn't get a chance to get the handouts printed out tonight, but if you have a computer, you can go. It is on our website, and let me know, and I can print you out a copy Sunday. But if you have a computer, you can go to our website and click the Sermons tab, and you can get a copy of the handout as well as this PowerPoint and any other things. Audio and video files of this message at heargodsword@bethlehem.com. But tonight we're going to talk about in the time of trouble, in the time of trouble. But before we get into this message tonight, I pose a question, and I want you, maybe you can answer it out loud with me. Help me kind of teach this message tonight, but my question to you tonight is, what is your most prized possession? What is your most prized possession? Anybody want to answer that tonight?
My wife.
Your wife. Amen. My wife. I ain't stupid. Yeah, my wife too. Thank you, brother. Yeah. Yeah. Anybody else? Your most prized possession.
Suck it up, honey.
Man. Well, Brian answered it, so I'll say my husband, but I do prize my grandchildren and I prize my relationships.
Amen. That's wonderful. Amen. She said her husband. Sister Eton, you say your husband. Grandkids and relationships. And that's, I mean, really, when you get down to true meaning of life, you answered those questions, because many times, if I wasn't in such a spiritual place, somebody probably would have said their car. They may not say it, but they act like it. They treat it so well, keep it clean, wax down, and, you know, and cover it up, put it in the garage, and, you know, keep it clean. Now, some folk can't drive the car, can't eat in the car. Some folk got to take the shoes off to get in my car. Don't let somebody get caught in the rain, a little mud on. No, 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 you ain't getting in this car. But, and other things, you know, like houses, you treat those really well, and money. Definitely money. Money, money, money can be a prized possession, and you treat it, and really you tell what is really a prized possession to you by the way you treat it. You know, and I accuse my wife sometimes about the house, you know, say, you try to keep this place like it's a museum. I can't live in here. But you prize, you know, whatever you prize, you're going to really take good care of it, right? Right? I couldn't help but to think that if you were to ask David what his most prized possession would have been, at least by this text, he probably would have said, the house of the Lord. The house of the Lord. And he gives away his most prized possession by this text in 24 verses 4. It says, the one thing I have desire of the Lord, that I will seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord. David's most prized possession was not what he possessed, but where he wanted to be. Not what he possessed, but where he wanted to be. And some of us are like that, you know, we prize a possession, but sometimes we don't realize it, but we prize the possession of home, especially when we're not at home. A little dark in the movie helped us to realize that what?
There's no place like home.
There's no place like home. And though she was away and getting to have all these different experiences in her life, the only place that she wanted to be was to be back home. And that's the way David was. He wanted to be in the house of the Lord.
Yeah.
He wanted to be in the temple. Now he was in a different dispensation than we are in right now. Back then, the temple was what? The place where who resided?
God.
The place where God resided. So his desire was to be in the house of the Lord. His desire was to be where God was. Was to be where God was. One of my most prized possessions is my home church. The church I came out of. Concord. I love to go back home. That's where I'm from. And many of you are like that with Bethlehem.
Another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.